What's going on, everybody, and welcome back to Comic Breakdown. If you guys are new to the channel, do me a favor and hit that sub button, hit that notification bell, and make sure you're not missing any of the awesome content we have coming out. Now, for this video, we're going to be jumping into Superman Action Comics, issue 1033. If you haven't been keeping up with this line, go ahead and check out the link in my description, as well as the top of this video. It will get you completely caught up on everything going on with Action Comics. Now, before we dive into this, I gotta say that Philip Kennedy Johnson has absolutely killed it in this issue. The writing in this one is absolutely phenomenal, and the buildup for what's about to happen is even better. This is probably my favorite comic from this week. And one last thing before we jump into this issue, I wanted to let you guys know that next week and part of the week after, I will be going on vacation. I'm going to see my kids down in Florida, so my videos next week and possibly the week after are going to be a little bit late. We're going to continue to get caught up on everything going on. Just don't expect early releases or as many videos until I get back from Florida. And I'll be sure to keep you guys up to date in the community tabs and so on and so forth. And I'm also working on getting a Discord up so that we can communicate in that aspect as well. Now, with that being said, let's dive into this breakdown. Alright guys, so as we dive into this issue of Action Comics, we are picking up in the ocean. We are picking up right now with this elemental rock that the Atlanteans have kept under guard. And right now, they are getting infiltrated by two individuals that seem to be in some kind of camouflage. As they make their way inside, they get to this rock that seems to be the power source of this entire ship. And they have been sent here on the orders of Amanda Waller, because these individuals are members of Task Force X. Now, before they're able to grab this stone, this is when the Atlanteans show up behind them, letting them know that they are not going to be making it out of here. And that's when we pick up with the Justice League, currently sitting around the table discussing all of the matters that are currently pending against them. Because as it stands, the situation with Atlantis has gotten even worse now, with Amanda Waller sending in these thieves to try to steal this element that is currently in possession of Atlanteans. Right now, everything is on the brink of all-out war. Now, they're referring to this stone as the Genesis Fragment, and no one really can comprehend what it does or its power up to this point. They just know that it is a element of extreme energy, and thus the Atlanteans have claimed ownership over it. And what the humans have done with Amanda Waller sending these people in, Atlanteans believe this as an act of war. And so the Atlanteans, in response, they have put up a blockade, blocking out all shipping routes through Atlantic Ocean area. And so as it stands, all-out war could break out at any second. Now, Batman tries to tell Arthur that everything that happened in Florida, after we saw everything transpire there, did you really think that the US government would sit by and let Atlantis control the Genesis element? And Arthur, you know, his response is, I didn't really know what you guys would do. I didn't know what the US government was going to do. I didn't think that they would try to send in some spies and steal it. Now, Arthur isn't king of Atlantis, and though his words may have some sway, the Atlanteans are going to do what they want to do. But while they are arguing over this, Superman interrupts. He chimes in and lets them know that they are not focusing on the bigger picture here. The bigger picture being that the Genesis element, it came to them from Warworld in a ship full of slaves. And so Warworld is the situation that they should currently be addressing. Because if Warworld is a world of slaves, then the Justice League should be focusing on that entirely. But Batman tells them that they cannot leave Earth right now. Warworld is not the immediate threat as the Atlantis situation is. Because Batman believes that Warworld, they didn't bring the Genesis Fragment as some kind of super weapon or powering some kind of massive armada. They lost it. If they knew what they had, they would have weaponized it already. And so before they actually deal with that, they have a world war that they need to prevent. Now, Arthur, up to this point, he's done hearing anything that Batman has to say. Getting up and walking away, Batman recognizing that this might be the beginning of an arms race. This is my favorite part, because this is when Superman, he puts his foot down. He tells him straight up, stop. He tells Arthur and Batman that he wasn't finished talking. And I love the authority that his voice commands anytime he speaks. Because when he says this, everybody in the room stops and they look at him. And he lets them know straight up that he is not here today to resolve international disputes or to decide the allocation of resources. He is here because there is a ship full of slaves, runaway slaves that are needing their help. Their bones are broken, their lungs are hurting. They might not even survive this. And while he understands the worry of everything else going on, he's asking them to look past themselves, to look past their fear, and look at their true situation going on here. No, as it stands, how many people are up there being slaves, being starved, being abused? And he tells the Justice League that him and his family, they're not going to allow anybody's lives to be lost over a stupid little rock. That they will fix this, but he vows that once he does, he is leaving to Warworld. And this is when we pick up with Tao La, one of the refugees from Warworld, currently practicing all of her new abilities ever since arriving on Earth. And these powers, these abilities, they seem to be maybe not superior to Superman, but they are definitely different, while also at the same time resembling their anatomy in very particular and interesting ways. But as it stands, right now she's worried about her friends because they haven't woken up yet. And right now they just have no answers. They don't know enough about their anatomy, how they react to the sun. They don't know anything about these people, so it's going to be really hard for them to diagnose anything. And more or less, it's a matter of just waiting till they do wake up. Now, while all of this is going on, John Kent has been really cold towards her. He's been cold towards her because he's been to the future. Somebody arrives on Earth at some point in time and takes his father away from Earth. And John is worried that this may be that moment. These may be that people that take him away. And Lois Lane, she does her best to try to explain this to Tao La. To explain that he just doesn't understand. He's too young to understand that Clark would never stay away from Earth as long as he had breath in his lungs. And this is when Lois Lane, she tries to kind of extend a peace offering. A small toy from back on Krypton. Something that Clark had made for Jonathan. And in trying to give her this toy, she rejects it. Almost as if this were an insult. Because she sees it as Lois Lane calling her a child. And this is where we learn why they have their chains on them. Going on talking about how she's strong. How she is not a child, and these chains prove it, because these chains are earned in battle. After every battle on Warworld, the losers must give iron to the victor. In this way, the victor's reach grows, while the loser's lessens. The weight of the iron makes the victor stronger, while it makes the loser weaker. And so each link, it represents a victory in battle. Now, while she is having this discussion with Lois Lane, this is where we see Mongol watching from some kind of observation television. And he's seeing her and believing that she is failing, that she's not going to continue with her task. And as it stands, she may need some more guidance. And so Mongol tells his people to activate the box, to remind her that her master is watching. And this is where we see inside those prison cells, all these prisoners that want to crack at Superman, one of them has a glowing object in their chest. And one of the other fighters ripping this guy's chest open, we see some kind of little box. And so we're seeing these guys are extremely loyal to Mongol. And it appears maybe even Tao La is here on ill intentions. But that's when we pick up in the Atlantic Ocean. Right now with the standoff with the US government and the army of Atlantis. And the US government telling Atlantis that they need to stand down. That this is their last chance, and if they don't stand down, they will open fire. Now, of course, Atlantis, they do not care. They are ready for war. They've been ready for war since the beginning. And as things start to escalate, this is when we hear the voice of the most commanding individual around. This is when we see Superman. And he's brought along with him Supergirl and Superboy. Because Superman isn't playing around. He wants this situation handled. And what better way to handle this situation to bring your entire super family? Because who's gonna question these three? And Superman tells them if anybody fires a single shot, they're gonna answer to Superman himself. And Superman, he tries to resolve the situation the best he can, but neither of them are budging. And Superman tells them that there has to be another way. We have to be able to find another course of action that doesn't revolve in war and allows the shipping containers to go through, because as it stands, this is hurting the world on a major scale with these waters being closed. But Atlantis is standing firm that if a single ship comes into their waters, it will be sunk, and that they are willing to fight anybody who goes against them, and that includes Superman and his family. Now, picking back up with Tao Law, she is sitting here over her friends as they are currently unconscious, waiting for them to wake up. She is currently crying. She's sad because of the things she's going to have to do. She really does care about these people here, cares about their kindness. And so really, it's confused her. When she got here, she expected Kal-El to be some great warrior like on Warworld, but she comes to learn that he is a much gentler individual. And she knows what has to be done, but she fears she may not be able to do this by herself, because she truly believes that these people, they don't deserve what's going to happen to them. And as she is confessing all of this information, this is when our prisoner from Warworld comes up from behind her, somehow teleporting in with this little box that he pulled out of this guy's chest, allowing them to get here at the Fortress of Solitude. And he has come here to teach Tao Law a lesson, to remind her that Mongol is watching and she is currently failing. Now, she swears up and down that she is going to continue everything she was told to do, that she is going to do Mongol's bidding. And as this struggle is going on, Lois Lane is overhearing all of this. And with the situation looking extremely sticky, Lois Lane runs into the other room to grab something, all while Tao Law, her eyes are getting ready to blast this dude in the face. But before she gets the opportunity, this guy gets shot in the back. Gets shot in the back by Lois Lane. And we see Lois toting a rifle, telling these guys that she has no idea how they got in here, and she doesn't care why she was sent here, she doesn't care what she was sent here to do, that Tao Law is now family to them, and when you pick a fight with family, you pick a fight with all of them. And I gotta point out the Fast and the Furious meme that has just been set up for this. All about family. Dom would 100% put his stamp of approval on this. But that will be the end of this issue. So let me know what you guys think down in the comments. You know, personally, I really did enjoy this issue, because it was a lot of fun seeing Superman. You know, he doesn't always use that authority that he has. Because at the end of the day, Superman, he could break any of these guys. And they all know that. And usually, he lets negotiation, he lets people have their say. But we really saw him fed up with all of the BS. We saw Superman who has one goal in mind. And that is, if there are other people that may be branch-offs of Kryptonians, and they're on an entire planet that is enslaved, he feels like he has no other duty than to go focus on that 100% right now. And so you can only imagine how irritated and how PO'd Superman must be right now that the Atlanteans and the US government, the UN, are clashing like this, when he really wants to focus on more important issues, not a stupid freaking rock. But yeah, let me know what you guys think down in the comments. If you have not yet, do me a favor, hit that sub button, hit that notification bell, make sure you're not missing any of the awesome content we have coming out. And until the next breakdown.